son of a... What tiny fist that a rat built? Oh, wait a second. The thing is on. It's... Hello? Hello. This is Mort McCoy. And welcome to the first of Headmaster Mort's EduTapes. Today we're talking about your camp. Now, former Vault resident or someone who killed a Vault resident, let's start off with the basics. Placing your camp. When plunking down your camp, C-A-M-P, that's an acronym, for the first time, remember to... Remember to take the lay of the land. Consider the grade of the terrain, general defensibility, and proximity to your surroundings. Could that clipped edge be used to protect your flank? You bet your chops it could. Once you've found the perfect spot, it's time to move on to the best part of working with your camp. Construction! Construction can be an intricate process, so a steady hand and an eye for detainment details. Damn, I had to get that one wrong. An eye for details are a must. You should take a moment to familiarize yourself with the camp's patented intuitive construction interface. But don't worry, we'll cover construction in gory detail in the next of Headmaster Mort's EduTapes. So long. Get your jobs. Come on, Mort. What was that? Hello, dedicated listeners. Welcome back to Headmaster Mort's EduTapes. Today, in this second tape, we are talking construction. Now, the first step of construction is... Wait, what? Is that soda? Soda's red, right? Wait, well... Electing. First, electing what you're going to build. Once you've made that election, it's just three easy questions to construction success. One, is the location I've selected going to work for an object of the size and shape I'm building? Two, have I read the schematics thoroughly? And three, do I have all the required materials to... Who the hell bled on my notes? Saul! If I find out it was you, you're gonna bleed on... Whatever. Just finish work. Short on materials? Loot the local junkyard, mills, and warehouses for parts. Missing a critical schematic? Your local vendors might have just what you're looking for. And on that note, this has been Headmaster Mort's EduTapes. EduTapes. See you again soon. Solomon, so help me, this better be Jen. Where are you hiding? Welcome back, lovely listeners, to Headmaster Mort's final tape in the camp series, Powering Your Camp. After listening to the second tape, you should already be well-trained enough to build a generator. If you haven't yet done so, I'll wait. Screw it. Alright, I'll assume you nailed it. Now, generators are the heart of your camp power system. Once your generator is built, all you need to do is connect it to the object that needs power with a wire. Though, be aware, your wire will need a clear, unobstructed path to establish and maintain a direct connection. Some objects, however, like simple light bulbs, do not require a direct connection. All you need to do is run a wire from your generator to a power pylon. Place the power pylon near your lights, then voila, let there be light! Well, this has been Headmaster Mort's Camp Construction Holotapes. Please check back with Headmaster Mort himself at The Wayward to learn more about his other exciting courses, including... Mort, can I still eat this? And mutations. Am I a monster now? And thanks again for listening. Ha! Nailed it!
Oh, hey there. Looking forward to hearing what you thought of those tapes. Now, what'd you want to discuss? Did you now? What did you think? Ha. If I needed smoke blowing up my ass, I'd sit on a campfire, okay? That bad, huh? Well, thanks for listening to him. Now, was there something else I could do for you? Allergies. Learned the hard way. I can't stand within 10 feet of a stroke. Come on, man. That's a joke. True. Now, you see, I drove, and it was like someone dropped a hurricane on it. I can hear bang. I wake up, man, and it's crazy. Something. All it cost me was my skin, and that was the day I became. I did, and your eyes still working, kids. That's the reason you're bringing up the obvious. Look, the world's hard now. Better you learn that lesson real fast. Some other time then.
You think the place looks good now? Wait till we're done rebuilding. Just need those hoodlums to stop breathing down our collective necks.
intruder. Identify yourself. Hostile target identified. Attention, fugitive should be considered armed and dangerous. Thank you.
should head to that camp. Find the overseer.
Clean up this, fix that. Never seems to end.
Thank you.
approach and identify yourself. Law-abiding citizens will not be harmed.
Thank you. It's just about time to eat.
Overseer's log, town of Flatwoods. My God, there's no one here. The old tavern, the church, people were using them for shelter, but they're gone. Mutations we expected. But there's something else. A disease. I was attacked by... Well, it used to be a person. But it had these green, glowing lesions, and its voice. Angry. Tortured. We are one. One what? Whatever happened here is beyond anything we expected. And we expected a lot. Before they were wiped out, the survivors called themselves the Responders. Looks like they were made of firefighters, police, emergency medical staff. They even have an automated system to teach people about treating water, food, survival. I'm doing their tests, and you should too. I know it's even worse than we imagined, but someone's got to know where the missile silos are and how to secure them. The Responders are the best lead we have. This is the Overseer, signing off.
Chloe looks.
Are you here for the responder training? Then you're not alone. A lot of people come here because of that radio message the responders left. At first, I was planning to just do the training and move on, but I really enjoy meeting all the people that passed. Wait a minute. Are you one of those people who... I knew it! I've always thought that life in a vault must be so amazing. Best of all, you're safe, which, though I guess you're one of us now. Go right ahead. Me? There's not much to tell, really. But eventually I wanted to go my own way, you know? When I heard the message on the radio about, I decided to stay here and see what else... It's a community of settlers up in the mountains to the east. It's a nice enough place, I guess. That being said, it's a hell of a dangerous trip trying to get there. I barely made it out of the mountains alive. If I were you, I'd keep to the forest until you're ready to deal with some seriously nasty stuff. He's the closest Foundation has to a leader, I guess. I never got to know him real well, but he always seemed like a decent guy. Okay, what is it? I found it in one of the houses. It fits great, and I'd also be lying if I said it didn't have sense. What they stood for, helping people... Yeah, there's a couple of places around here that qualify as interesting. The Agricultural Research Center is infested with feral ghouls and homicidal robots. But you can find some good scrap in there if you're up to it. The New River Gorge Resort to the east is the same story. Maybe, minus the robots. No problem.
Interview 2, Reverend Delbert Winters. Hi, I met you in the woods near the Morgantown Airport. warning to all responders. The Mr. Farmhands are out of control.
Dasa has asked us all to document our stories for posterity, you know. It seems like a fine idea. So, hi, I am Kesha McDermott. When the bombs fell, I was in Watoga, coordinating a statewide science fair for that year's high school kids. And the theme was the future of energy. After the bombs, everything was pretty chaotic. Scavenging for food and fighting off rabid survivors. Oh, it was just a bad time all around. I found a couple of surviving kids from the high school whose parents didn't make it. And we holed up in a house in town for a while. After a bit, I was able to solder the circuitry in an old radio, and we tuned in to a broadcast from the responders. Oh, we were overjoyed. The trip from Watoga to Flatwoods, it was rough, mind you. The kids and I ran into a group of assholes in the mountains who stole our food and water. I can't tell you how happy I was to find the responders in Flatwoods. Tents for everyone, open kitchens, medical supplies, protection. We were safe. They had a problem, though. Their water sources were contaminated heavily. Boiling water, but not long enough to make it safe. So, I stepped up and I said, I'll build a testing kit to monitor the contamination and I will teach folks how to properly boil water. And I did. The world is getting better, but slowly. We need to make sure it doesn't relapse too. It's going to take time and care, that's all. Well, time, care, and science.
At all. Compost reserve.
Thank you. automated message. The Forest Watch detects all supervisors down. Good job. Responder team, proceed to the Ag Center and get to the mainframe. You need to reset the farmhand targeting parameters. That should keep our people safe in the area. Be careful.
Biological material is required.
Chloe's my pet. Or maybe I'm hers. I'm not sure.